Uncover now 6 roadblocks to success. If you don't make the progress in your business that you want, this can have different reasons like wrong strategies, missing know-how, etc. In this video, I want to help you to uncover some of your psychological obstacles to success. Together, we'll get to the bottom of the question, what fear is behind your excuses? If you stick with me to the end, I promise you, you will uncover at least one or possibly even more of your success blocks. Once you uncover them, you can get rid of them. But on the other hand, until you uncover these fears and get rid of them for good or break through them, you will not move forward because you will constantly self-sabotage yourself, your business, and your success. So you have to uncover these. So fear number one, the fear of not being good enough. And you could tell that you have this fear by when you're unnecessarily being perfectionistic. Like, let me give you an example where you could see that. If you want to get out with a new offer to your audience, and instead of actually doing that, getting out there, organizing new potential customers, appointments with them, for example, you would go ahead and optimize your offer over and over and over and over, and you would lose days, weeks, or even months of your time, and you can't get the success that you want. Fear number two, the fear of rejection. And you can tell that you have this if you are weak in assertiveness. Like, for example, if you would have a social media channel and you're posting there about yourself, maybe your offers, and every time you figure something that you could post that would actually be very polarizing, then you go ahead and don't do it because you have a fear of what people would say. Or another example would be if you have fear of rejection, is that if you're in a sales situation and you can't do the hard questions, you can't go for the close, you can't go for the sale. So that's weak assertiveness. Fear number three, the fear of change. And you can obviously tell if everything is always kind of the same, especially when you know that you would need to innovate something in your business, but you're not doing it. Like, one example could be if you're selling your offers only offline, but you know you have to go online with your business and you're not doing it. Fear of speaking in front of people. Obviously, you know that you have that fear in situations like if you would imagine you go on a stage and you would talk to an audience, how would that make you feel? Or if you are in a networking meeting and you have an opportunity to pitch your offer in 60 seconds, which is a typical thing to do at network meetings, and you feel like your blood pressure goes up, you start sweating, or you know that you might want to go live on Facebook or on social media, or you want to open a YouTube channel, and every time you think about it, you can't do it because you just fear the camera in your face and the people watching you talking to them. Fear of losing people, that would be the fifth one. You can obviously recognize it when you think about somebody might get rid of you. Let me give you an example again. Like, if you, especially if you're self-employed, you are the business, right? And if you would go ahead and change your complete business, or you change your offer completely to something totally new, and that would mean that you would have to also change some parts of your identity in order to be able to make that change in your business, right? First, you change it in your inside, your identity, and then you would have to transport it, communicate it to the outside. And now if you think about doing that, and then thoughts would come up like, hey, my partner, my spouse, my husband would not really like me anymore, that's a problem. Or if you would feel like customers would leave or business partners would leave, that's when you know that you have a fear of losing people, and it blocks you from moving forward and getting the success that you want. And the sixth fear I would like to help you uncover is the fear of success itself. And you can recognize it by the fact that one or more signs of success actually frighten you. Like, for example, you want to grow with your business, want to make more money, also so that you would have more money. But at the same time, when you once you think about having more money, thoughts like, if I have more money, I would also have more problems. For example, because I would have a lot more envious people around me, etc., 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 would come up. So that's actually fear of success by itself. And you will have to go through it, or you will have to release that fear somehow in order to be able to actually get that success. It's really crazy because you want it at the same time, but you don't want it at the same time. So by now, we have gone through six fears, and just ask yourself, like, what blocks to success have you been able to uncover for yourself? Write it in the comments, or if you don't want to write that, give me some feedback in the comments about that, or ask some questions. I'm going to answer them for you. Basically, what we have just done here together is something that I would do together with my online business mentoring clients. Like, basically, it looks differently there, but I sense such blockages in order to dissolve them for my client so they can really break through to the success that they want. Like, breakthrough success that they never could get by themselves. That's one part of the work that I do for my clients. So if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe the channel, because there's gonna come a lot more for you. See you soon. Yours, Robert.